there, and welcome to our 4-week challenge. So if you didn't read or watch the intro video, please pause this video now and go back and watch that really fast. It's going to tell you how everything works, how the rep counts go, how the sets go, and all of that kind of stuff. So it's a lot of really, really important information that you need to know before you start the workouts. So if you haven't read it or watched it, please pause and go right now before we start. Okay, so this is week one of day one. I am usually gonna get right into the exercises because the intro explains everything. These videos are just to show you what the exercises look like so that you are able to accomplish the workout, okay? This young little man right here is my son, Adrix. He will be accompanying some of the classes only because, you know, he's my life right now. So he will be helping me at times. He can be my weight at times, just as if you have a little one at home, you can have a weight as well. So yeah, that will be Adrix. All right. Our first exercise is going to be a bicycle. So we're going to be on our backs. Make sure you have enough room to rotate. So legs should be out here. Make sure you have enough space for both. Hands are going to be at your ears, elbows out. One leg is going to be hovering above the ground. The other leg is going to be bent in this motion right here. So if this is too much, just drop this leg, okay? If you want to make sure you feel this in your abs, not your lower back. So if lifting it up right here puts too much strain on your back, then I want you to drop it until you have the strength in order to keep it up, okay? So bicycle looks like this. You're trying to get your opposite shoulder to that knee, and you're going to alternate side to side. Notice how my shoulders are staying off the ground, and I'm not trying to get them done as fast as possible. One leg is straight, one leg is bent, and I'm just alternating side to side, like so. That, my friends, is a bicycle. Second exercise, cross body super push. So you're going to start in a plank position. We are going to be doing one set of cross body mountain climbers, followed by a release push-up Superman hold. You're going to hold the Superman for about 5 seconds, and then you're going to release and push up and begin again. I will show you and demo it now. Thank you. So, plank position. We have cross body mountain climber. Lower all the way down. Superman hold for about 5 seconds, and then press all the way up into that push-up position. Cross body, lower down. Superman hold, press up, cross body. Great? Sounds fun? It is. Third exercise, we have squat to press. So I mentioned in the intro video and a little bit in the description. So you will need a set of light weights. I'm using 8 pounders. You can also use 10 or 12. You can also use up to 5. If weights are not available to you right now, I got mine at Target, but if you, you know, don't have the money to spend or you don't want to or whatever it is, you can also use books. That can help as well if you have some heavy books at home, dictionaries, that kind of thing. So you do have other options, okay? So we have squat to press. You're going to be in a squat position, well, standing position. Feet are going to be hip distance, hip distance or shoulder width, depending on the flexibility of your calves. Weights are going to be on your shoulders like this. You're going to squat down. Knees stay in between your toes and your heels. So you never, ever, ever want to do this. That is bad news bears. It puts a lot of pressure on your knees and it injures you. So you don't want to do that, okay? You want to squat as if you're trying to squat into a toilet that you don't want to touch. Girls, you know what I'm talking about. Guys, you probably have no idea. But it looks like this. Squat it all the way down, go as low as you can, and then you're going to press all the way up. So when you're pressing up, you have to engage your abs so that you're not arching your lower back like this. So nice and solid. Squat, press. Weights in your heels, toes are up nice and light. You should be able to wiggle your toes the whole time you're doing the squat, okay? That is a proper form for squat to press. Burpees, everybody's favorite. I love burpees. Said no one ever. Okay, so in my class, chest hits the ground, feet off the ground. Looks like this. Jump into a plank, all the way down, all the way up, press up. Burpees. Beautiful, right? It takes 5,200 burpees to burn off a thing of McDonald's french fries. Think
about that next time you go to a fast food restaurant. Okay. Single leg row. So we already need our weights for this one again. From here, so you're gonna balance on one leg. So all of your weight goes into one leg. This leg is here to A, support you, or B, challenge you a little bit. So if you have a little bit of a balance issue, keep this foot on the ground just to help, okay? A lot of times just feeling the floor with this foot helps loads with your balancing. You're going to lean forward. If you don't have an issue with balancing, then you can lift the leg up. But what I'd like you to do is to point the toes towards the ground to keep the hips parallel with the ground. So we're starting here, balancing on one leg. You're going to bring your elbows up, keeping the balance, abs engaged. Now, with this, you can keep your palms facing together or you can rotate, whatever you want. You can also go in. Whoop. But don't fall. If you fall, get back up and do it again, it's okay. And then of course, alternating sides. Remember, do whatever you do on one side, you need to do on the other. And that, my friends, is day one. Have fun.